Now we're going to move on to key effects. Now key effects, there's a whole lot of key effects, and we're going to split them up into a couple different categories. But the first off, we're going to talk about the basic concepts of key effects, and then we're going to go into the seven most used key effects that there are in that you're going to want to be using. Now key effects, unlike oscillation effects, where in oscillation effects you have a start and an end point, key effects are effects where you have a start and end point, but inside there you can create as many different positions of as you want. So instead of having a start and finish, you have a timeline here. It's a mini little timeline. And you can add key effects anywhere in between the 0% and the 100%, and anywhere in between, wherever you want them. And each of these keys can have different values to these keys. And so you can create yourself an interesting array, and you're basically your own custom movements. Instead of it being a back and forth type of thing with oscillation effects, you can create your own custom keyed out thing. And inside of here, the key effect, this area right here is always going to be the same in all the key effects. Now, the way this also goes is the timing is the 0% to 100%. This is the time of which this here. So it's 1 second or it's one beat. So 0% to 100%, that becomes the beginning of the second or the end of, to the end of the second, and then it will repeat. As well, you can also click on these and right-click, and then you can add the accelerations to them as well as we had before. So if you want to create a really crazy custom animation inside of an effect, you can do that. So it's loaded down, you can kind of see it plays along this whole line of all these things that I've added, and you can create those things. So you can add those accelerations, and that's how it goes. I'm gonna start this over real fast. When you create a key effect, a lot of the time what you're going to do is say, okay, well, at the beginning, I think you'll want it to be, let's say, it'll start at 0, right? And then at 50%, I want it to be at 100%. And then at the end, I want it to go to 50. And then I'll jump back to 0% when it resets. You can go in here, and then you can, when you move this little line here, which is your time marker, when you move that to where you want the next one to be, and you move something, it'll automatically create it, and that's this enable. This is where you enable that. You can disable that, and when you change stuff, it won't actually change this until you create a key. You can delete them this way, or you can right-click and delete them as well. You can also lock positions if you've got it exactly where you want it and you don't want to accidentally move it. You can lock the position of that as well. You can remove that and delete that. So all the key effects go off this basic premise of a 0 to 100% in this time period that you set. And inside of there, you can add as many keys as you want, and you can modify to be whatever you like it to be. Now, with key effects, there's going to be seven that you're going to use a whole lot. I'm just going to add them all at once so we can talk about them. You're going to use size. You're going to use rotation. You're going to use position. You're going to use brightness. You're going to use color. You're going to use visible points, which is over here. And you're going to use scan rate. Now, these seven are the default. When you create an event in timeline, these are the default effects. And for most practical purposes, you can create pretty much everything you might want to make using these effects in a basic sense. Of course, you can't get too crazy, but you can get a lot done with just these seven effects. So we're going to go through those, and these are the basic, most used effects that you're going to want to be using. Size, as you can imagine, scales it. Let's say, you know, just a quick example, if we wanted to start at 0, we want to end at 100, you can right-click there, and that'll default it to 100, or you can click and type it in. And there you go, that's keyed out. Rotation is pretty self-explanatory. We can rotate on all the axes. Let's say 0%, we want it to be at this, we want to say 20, get 30 degrees. And then at 100%, it'll be, let's keep it negative 30, and then at the 50% mark, it'll be negative 30 degrees. Right there. So you can see now that this is keyed out. Position works similarly. We can, create positions back and forth. If I want to create a key that way, so now it's the same position, and then back at the 50%, we can maybe do that, and this we can reset this. So now you have three keys, where, you know, negative back to the beginning, negative again. Brightness works by controlling the entirety of the of the shape or the frame. This is brightness, so maybe we want to say we want to fade it in, and then we want to fade it out, so we can create a key there, and then fade it out at the end, so it fades in and fades out at the beginning and at the end of the period. Color, this is a recolor tool. It's a mass recolor tool. If you basically, when the alpha is active, it will create it, it'll default to white, and then you can take out blues, you can take out the red, you can take out the green, or you can add them, whatever, and then you can color mix and create your own color. That'll override the entirety of the thing. If you don't want to override, there's hue scroll and there's different color options. We're going to go into that later. But this is a basic recolor that you can add later on if you want to recolor a frame, or it's not a shape, so you can't simply do it up here and change your color. You can use the recolor there. Then visible points is kind of a drawing tool. So if we pull in on one side, pull in on one side, we can kind of, it pulls and draws. So let's do this. Let's try when it fades in, we'll have it draw in. And then when we fade out, we will have it draw out again. So it draws in and then draws back out. And then the last one is scan rate, which we can't really show you here. But if you've ever played the scan rate down in the live event, it's pretty... It brings the points per second down on whatever. So let's say at the near the middle, we want it to scan down. So when it were to happen, it reached this point and start scan down, and then it would scan back up. So you can create those types of effects. And these are the seven basic effects that you're going to be using on a daily basis and are the seven default effects in a timeline event. And really, for the most part, you'll find yourself using these mostly. And you can get a lot done with all of these effects.